everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is not a Star Wars review or haul. It is another figure review. This time it is on a Pirates of the Caribbean figure. As you can see, and really fast, I do want to say I am a pretty big fan of the first three Pirates of the Caribbean movies. They're pretty good. I like them. I didn't really care too much for the fourth one, but the first three I really love. So, but today we are taking a look at Elizabeth Swann from Series 3. And before anything, we will take a look at the packaging. Now, this figure is made by NECA, and usually NECA figures come in a clamshell, and she did. And what I did is I just took this out, because I usually do keep my packaging and stuff, but I just took this out. It, you know, less room, stuff like that. And I also cut the picture and her name out from the packaging as well, so just easier for space and stuff, and then threw the clamshell out. As you can see, there was a pirate skull right there, the Pirates of the Caribbean logo, C3. On the back, on the side, here is a picture of the figure, another picture of the figure, and then the other figures in the wave. I would like to get the Will Turner one and Captain Barbosa. I kind of do want all of them because these are pretty nice figures in it, what it looks like below. And you can open it up, and it's how to connect them. So I thought that was pretty cool. And then all the names and stuff. So that's pretty cool. And then, so there's that. We would take Elizabeth off her base. Her articulation really fast is a ball joint head. A little hindered because her hair is in the way, but it's not too bad. Ball hinged shoulders. Hinge at the wrist, and swivels in the legs, which doesn't make too much sense because she is wearing a dress. First of all, I do want to say she's my favorite character of the movies. I really loved her. She was one of my first movie crushes, actually. I love this figure. I think the detail is really nicely done on her. You can see all the wrinkles and folds. The dress right here is a hard plastic, and then this part of the dress is a rubbery plastic, and it is a separate piece. You can see the ruffles right here, and it's pretty nicely done. Under there you can see her shoes, and then she has another underdress. On the back, has very nice texturing, and you can see all the wrinkles and folds and stuff like that. Pretty cool folds and wrinkles on her sleeves and the ruffles right here. Her hair is a rubber, like the bottom dress part of the dress is right here. So, want to kind of be careful with her. Don't mess with her hair too much because it probably can come off. I actually used to have this figure a long time ago, and her hair actually did come off. So, yeah, she's pretty nicely done. Her face sculpt, it does resemble Keira Knightley a lot. I think she looks evil for some reason, just because it might be her arch eyebrows. But she does. It's a beautiful figure. I think they did a great job on it. This is probably my favorite look of Elizabeth throughout the movies. I just, throughout the movies, Elizabeth, her evolution of the character evolved. You know, at first, in the first movie, she was kind of a damsel in distress. She needed to be saved. And in the second movie, she, you know, was kind of transforming into that pirate like everyone else. And in the third movie, she was full on pirate mode, using a sword and fighting, and didn't really need saving anymore, and she's tough. And I think that was a really good evolution for the character. Her accessories include this knife, and she the reason she comes with this knife is because this figure is depicted off when she has dinner with Captain Barbossa, and she tries to kill him, and she realizes he can't die, so, pretty nice detail. It's just pretty much all just one color. And it can fit in her hand, either way. You can either have her hold it like that, or you can take it out and maybe have her hold it like this, like she's going to stab Captain Barbossa. I kind of think she looks like a psycho like that, so I tend to leave her, like this way. So, yeah. Or if you really wanted to, I'm sure you could give her a sword. Even though she doesn't really use a sword in the first movie. But the knife is pretty cool. She also does come with the medallion right here. It's tied on with a string. I don't think it's removable, but I'll try to get close in on that. Pretty nice detail on it. They don't mention that, as you can see right here. They only mention she comes with a knife and base. They don't mention that. And on the figure, on the packaging, she's not wearing the medallion, so. And then she also does come with a base. Pretty nicely done base. You can see a bunch of coins there, and you can see a glass cup here and pearls there. And I really like this effect. They put a clear plastic on top of it, and you can see it's supposed to resemble water, and you can see coins under the water and stuff. I really like this base. Pretty nicely done. She does stand well on her own. She doesn't really need the base, but just for purposes, since she did come with it, I do like her displayed on the base. She looks a lot better too. So this is pretty nicely done figure. I do want to just say, the hair does seem a little darker. I kind of wish it was this color how it is on the packaging right here. But it does seem, maybe her hair was wet, and sometimes hair gets darker when it is wet. So, and her hair was wet throughout the movie. She was in the water a lot, so not a big difference. So, there are many Elizabeth Swann figures. I do have one 3-inch one that I had for a while now. I forgot to bring it to show in the video, but I do want to get other 6-inch ones. I think I'm going to try to get all the Elizabeth Swann figures, and then maybe get some other characters. I really don't want to get into collecting anything else, but since Elizabeth is my favorite character of the movie, I do want most of the figures of her. So this was a review on the NECA Pirates of the Caribbean Series 3 Elizabeth Swann figure. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my videos, our channel, and have a great day, and until next time.